Ultima nga kiatu malugarong konferensya di idioma yama Caribbean Today, Language Awareness and Language Development. Profesional di varios países nos region a uni pa diskutie materia di conscientizasyon y desarrollo di idioma. Experto nga kiada impresyona ko e determinasyon di nos na Aruba pa inkluí papiamento de nos sistema edukasyonal unda te hasta inkluí material na skol di nos lengua materna. Aruba ta ejempl ideal pa otro país ng den Caribe.
Professor Nicholas da di Università di Puerto Rico con amplio studio ribe materia di idioma. E ta comparti conosco la situazione di sua ultima investigazione tana Centustasias, un isa cu mescos conos aqui na Aruba, e idioma di instruzione ta differente con nang lengua materna.
Language of instruction in the schools has been Dutch, but the people in St. Eustatia, they don't speak Dutch, they speak English. So we just did a research project there, inspired by places like Aruba and what you've done with Papiamento, looking at the situation there for the Dutch government. They asked us to do a research project to find out what the people of the island felt about what should be the language of instruction in the schools, what language should they use in the schools to teach the children. Also, how people feel about Dutch, how people feel about English, which is the language that the people speak. Also to test the students and how well they're doing in Dutch and English. And what we found is that really teaching in Dutch is not helping people either to learn English or even to learn Dutch. That actually the levels in Dutch and the levels in English are both very low now. And what's really disturbing is a lot of the young people now have very negative attitudes towards Dutch.
Ideal o tapa tur gente que da positivo cu tur idioma, pero curiosidad talanta pa kiko tanto negativismo pa cu edidos idioma.
And then people explain to us it's because Dutch is being forced on people in the schools, being forced on the students. They're not ready to cope with the Dutch when they get to school, and they really have a problem. So it's making them have a negative attitude. And this is very bad because where I live in Puerto Rico, there are very negative attitudes towards English. Why? Because the United States for 50 years tried to impose English on the people, tried to force Puerto Ricans to study in English, to learn to read and write in English instead of in Spanish. Even though now all the schools are in Spanish in Puerto Rico, they've been that way since the 1950s. For 50 or 60 years, people still don't want to learn English. So it's a big problem. If we don't teach Dutch the right way, if we force it on the students, we are going to end up with the same problem as we have in Puerto Rico, where the students are going to start to hate Dutch. They become adults, they have children, and that hatred towards Dutch is going to continue.
Ta crea un situación desagradable ora cu forza un studiante sinha un idioma cu ta diferente na su lengua materna. Non solamente è molto talento con attitudine negativa per quel idioma specifico aqui, però è che da zuak dentro suo idioma.
What we proposed in Stacia was to have English as the language of instruction in all the schools in Stacia, but to have Dutch as a strong foreign language, because it's a foreign language in Stacia. Most children in St. Eustatius never hear Dutch until they get to school. That means it's a foreign language. Your language base has to be good, and the best way to get a good language base is in your own language, Papiamento. If you get a good base in your own language, Papiamento, first, then you can learn Dutch easily. But if you have to go from the known to the unknown, from what the children know to what they don't know, so if they can get a good base in Papiamento, reading and writing in Papiamento, it will be easy for them to learn to read and write in Dutch. But if you expect them to read and write in Dutch before they can read in Papiamento, you have a problem, because not only they're learning to read, not only they're learning how to write, but they're also learning a foreign language at the same time. So this is why the Dutch people are so good in foreign languages. Many Dutch people can speak English. Why? Because they learn to read and write in Dutch first, then they go to English. So all that we're saying is the people in Aruba should have the same opportunity. The children should have the same opportunity. Get a good foundation in Papiamento first, and then go on to Dutch.
E professor ta sigi commentar cu un bon manera tapa inicia cu un di dos idioma de un forma menos formal e ora è mucha desarrolla bon de un su lengua materna po por sigi pa otro idioma nan.
It's about going step by step, not jumping. If we jump, some people can jump, but not everybody can jump. We want to make sure that the school is not just helping the 5% of people who can jump. We want to make sure the school is also helping the 95% of people that have to go one step at a time.
Da hobby importante pa cada persona ti un bon fundeshi den idioma. Después di bon fundeshi den bolenga materna, po por sigi crese den otro idioma. Nos lo ampliaribe conferencia aquí de un próximo edición de Noticias Buenoche.